Hey guys, how are you doing, you beautiful, gorgeous people of the web? And thank you guys so much for clicking on my channel, because y'all know that you did the right thing, showing some love for your boy James. And we are back with another reaction video, and a few people have asked me to react to Partition by Queen Bey herself. And Partition has to be in my top five Beyoncé songs, because that song delivers in every capacity the definition of the meaning of a bop. And I remember, oh gosh, I remember being in a club, right? And I like all kinds of music, and it was something like Taylor Swift or something was playing. And I was like, yeah, I'm not really about that life. Like, so me and my friends were just sat there being a bit stush in the corner of the club. Yeah, they're like just sipping on a drinks. And then, yeah, Partition came on. And I can still see my friend's sister's face the way a ghetto ass got up off the seat. And she was like, ooh, like that. And we all just dominated that dance floor. But yeah, like I always say, I do not claim any of the copyright or video material, so always support the artist, stream by Beyoncé, and yeah, that's it. So we're going to, without further ado, we'll get into the video, because we probably will pause it. Of course, I know the song. I don't remember the music video, because I remember buying, I wasn't living in England at the time that this album dropped, so I was very late to the whole video concept of it. And I do think, I think the self-titled is my favourite Beyoncé album as well, because I adore Jealous and the remix with Chris Brown as well. But yeah, without further ado, if you are new to my channel, guys, do support your boy James, subscribe below, and don't forget, you know the drill, guys, to give the video a like. It. So yeah, let's do this. Such a bop. Drive around at the partition, please. I don't need you seeing your say on her knees. Hey. Stop, 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 stop. How sickening does Beyoncé look? Hold on, where is she at? Where you at? Who else? Complete savage, like literally, she just absolutely slays it, Beyoncé. And I don't, what can you say? The song is amazing. I miss my friends be vibing with me on this. Visuals and aesthetics of the video were so amazing as well, because you can just, like, Beyoncé is one of those people, I've already said it in previous reaction videos, that when you see her perform, or even when she's on camera, she just morphs into this creature that just uses sex appeal, stage presence, talent, inspiration, swag. Like, literally, Beyoncé is it, and she is Queen Bey for a reason. And I kind of fault her, and I think she's one of those artists that I prefer Beyoncé now. When she first came out, I was like, I didn't mind the odd song. I like Baby Boy, And then I think it was from Sasha Fierce where she kind of came into her own kind of phenomenon, and it's kind of grown and grown, and I've appreciated how she has incorporated her hip hop elements and roots. And for me, as a I feel like Beyoncé's only gotten better with her music and experimentation and everything like that as well. So yeah, let's continue. My gosh. And I kind of read that, I think she, I don't know if this is true or not, but I think when she went into the recording studio, she didn't have the lyrics written, so it was kind of like almost freestyling. And I think she heard the beat and she just kind of was like, drive around at the partition, please. And she kind of just got into it. And if that's true, that's absolutely amazing. And I have a little story to go with this, and I'm hoping this particular friend isn't subscribed to my channel because it'll start something up again. So I lived in Tenerife. I've said this in previous reaction videos. I kind of went to live in Tenerife for a year, and this is when this concert was. So I was devastated that I wasn't going to see this tour because I just knew that it would be absolutely amazing. And a friend of mine works in fashion, and he had VIP tickets for a meet and greet with Beyoncé and Jay-Z before the show in London. And I was like, oh my God. And I was like, I'm actually not living in Manchester anymore. I'm kind of like living in Tenerife at the moment. And I was like, do not speak to anybody else, but some way, somehow, I will be there. And I was running a store at the time, like I was running a shop while my manager was away. And I literally said to him, I was like, you've got to somehow let me have these dates to go back to London to see this concert because I'm going to meet Beyonce, basically. And I was like, how can I explain this to like a proper manly Londoner? Do you know what I mean, mate? And I was like, mate, like I literally have to go to this concert, and it's like the equivalent of the World Cup. Like, and British people will know, like, or European people, like the World Cup, soccer, football, whatever, where you're from, it's absolutely huge, the World Cup. And I was like, that's the equivalent of me seeing Beyonce. So like the guy like understood, and he was like, I'm gonna work around it, but I'll let you have it off. And then my friend changed his mind and was like, sorry to kind of like, I know that I said that you could go to the concert, but I've kind of asked my cousin to go instead because I felt a bit bad. So they both got to meet Beyonce, and I saw it on his Facebook, and I did not talk to him for a year. And the guy begged, he begged my friendship back, and I couldn't get over it, and I couldn't forgive him. And I was like, nope, stubborn. Every time the phone rang, it was silence. And yeah, because I'm that stubborn. Because how would you be, guys, if someone said, I've got a meet and greet, you're gonna meet Beyonce, and then they change their mind when you're literally gone to the lengths of the earth to change your plans with work and fly back to London to kind of go and see it? And I never got to meet her, and he did, and I'll always be bitter. But yeah, so that's my little Beyoncé story. So sorry to kind of go on for a bit there, but yeah, there's a little story for you. Je vais dire. It's just there. Like, it just makes you wanna. absolutely amazing. Like, honestly, like, I'm so glad you guys asked me to react to that. And I am aware that I have other artists that I do need to do, and I will get round to it. I've just been really, really busy this past week. I've not been home, so I will get to it. And yeah, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed that. Partition is definitely in my top five Beyoncé songs. I can't think of a list at the minute, but Jealous is in there, Partition, and then obviously I guess like Halo would maybe be there. But yeah, I do like I said, I like Beyoncé, the more mature that she's got, and like what she did with Lemonade. And I'm always for standing up for beliefs and things, and what she did with Lemonade was an absolute masterpiece, and she did deserve Album of the Year at the Grammy Awards. Yeah, that's it basically, guys. But I want to know your stories. I always say this in previous reaction videos, but I always want to know what your thoughts were when you first heard the drop of the self-titled album, because she done that surprise release. What are your favourite songs of the album? What do you guys think of Partition? And how does Partition make you feel? So, yeah, like I said, if you guys are new, please do click the link below, subscribe, suggest any videos. And once again, I want to thank all of you for your support, because it's incredible how fast my subscribers are rising, and it's all down to you guys as to why I continue to do this. So thank you so much, and please do not forget to give the video a like. It and our Freedom UK people is soon, those bars will be lifted soon. We need to hear WAP in a club. But yeah, thank you so much for clicking, and yeah, have a great day, guys.